What should people got an interesting DM from a person saying that he's looking to start an online vegetable business. In this business, he would be selling all his vegetables and groceries online to the localities nearby in his city. He's having a really low initial budget, so he's asking for advice. So I thought it's a good video, a good topic to create a video. Let me generalize it first. Then we will talk to his problem. Then let me generalize it first. When you are trying to start any online business, the best recommendation I could give is start small and aim for the sky. Don't go too much fancy, firstly. Don't ask for a custom built mobile application or custom built AI platform or those kind of stuff. When you are starting up, you have low budgets. Keep it low. Try to get things done and keep it low. So what is the profit in this? There are two profits. Firstly, you would understand the importance of funds and cash flow. The second thing would be, it would force you to be profitable. If you are starting up your online business, keep it small. Don't go fancy. There are n number of stuff which can get your things done. That's it. Let's just jump to his answer. Let's just first understand what he's trying to do. He's trying to sell vegetables online. When he's selling vegetables online, he needs an e-commerce website from where he would be able to sell those vegetables. First option is, he could go to agency, get a custom built e-commerce application and a website. It would cost him more than 3 to 4 lakh rupees. Then he would be able to start. So firstly, he's blocking 3 to 4 lakh rupees, and then he needs another 5 to 10 lakh rupees for marketing. That would be very expensive to start a business, and especially a grocery business which is too competitive. So what I recommend him is, don't be too fancy. Don't get too fancy. Just book a domain name. Once you book that domain name, just get a e-commerce website using, you can yourself build an e-commerce website using WordPress, or you can hire a freelancer from Fiverr.com or Upwork.com. He would happily build you a WordPress website in less than 15,000 rupees. You would be able to get a WordPress e-commerce website hosted on your servers. For domain, it would cost you less than 500 to 1000 rupees. For hosting for an AR, it will cost you around 2000 rupees. So these are 3000 rupees. And then for 15,000 for the e-commerce website. So this is the total of 17K. Then 1000 rupees will cost you to get a GST number. Once you have all these things, you are ready to go. So just build a website, add all your products. My friend, the job is not over yet. People will not come to your website and start buying. You need to market your website. So how would you market it? How would you market the website? And even people, most of the people, the mistake what most entrepreneurs do is that they think if they build a website, the job is done. No, job is not done. Building a website is just 20%. Marketing the website is 80%. So you have just done the 20% of the job. You need to complete the 80% as well. Then you would be able to build a business. To complete that 80% or to market the website, I would recommend him to create two main channels, YouTube and Instagram. These would be his two channels where he would do all his marketing. Initially, we would be building content surrounding these sectors. What sector I'm talking about? I'm talking about food and grocery. He would be building top videos like top 10 healthy biscuits, top 10 vegetables to eat for glowing skin, how to identify which vegetable is adulterated, which is not. So he would be building valuable content in these platforms, in YouTube and Instagram. Down the line, when you start building that content, all the people who would be seeing those content would build a perception in their mind that let me first give you one more thing. You are not selling on those videos. You would be just giving information. People would be coming to your channel for information. Once you're done with information, then in descriptions or in end of the video, you would be able to give your venture links. Like if you want to buy vegetables, you can just just head over to this website, this is my website, and these kind of stuff. So you are not just selling stuff, you are firstly giving value and then just informing the consumer that, hey, I have a website and if you want to buy these things, you can come to me. This is the thing. People, when you start to give value, people start to subscribe you. And once they start to subscribe, they start to dig into your profile and understand what you do. So they will do all the finding stuff and they will eventually reach to your website. Once they reach to your website, they would build a psychological perception that you are a good guy and your company is selling good products. Once they are done with this psychological thing, then in future, anytime they would be in need of grocery or things to be delivered on to their home, they would directly just go to your website. They would not go to your competitor or anyone, they would directly go to your website. The reason is, they have seen you providing value to them and they have a perception, a psychological perception back in their mind that you are a good guy and you would be able to give them good, great value. So this is a advice I would like to give him. Down the line, once in a year or two, he would be able to build good audience. Once he is done building that great audience, then he could opt for a mobile application. In that mobile application, he would be able to build a subscription-based model over there. In that subscription-based model, you would pay this much amount and these vegetables would be delivered to your home every month. So, or you could just upload your shopping list and the entire vegetable pack would be delivered to your home. So, but that is the thing of future. Once you have the funds, firstly you need to build those funds from your profits and then you would eventually go to that model. Once you run a Shopify store for a year or so and making decent profits, then you have basically evaluated your business that you are capable to do this business. And once you are done with that, then you could try to expand. Firstly, you need to be capable enough that you are and confident enough that you are able to do this, and then you can think of expanding. I hope this video added certain value to your life. Thanks for your time. Bye-bye.